good thing when Thistle put out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even, brightly shone the moon at night, though the frost was cruel, when the poor man came inside, gathering winter fuel. Here's a page and stand by me, if thou knowest telling, yonder peasant who is he, where and what is dwelling? For he lives a goodly can, underneath the mountain, right against the forest stand, by St. Agnes Fountain.
Welcome to How the Grinch Found Christmas by the Covington Bible Church Olympians.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose.
Wait a second. And if you Colt, that's the wrong song.
Who, what?
They're playing the wrong song.
Uh-uh.
It's not Rudolph, it's the Grinch.
Oh, yeah, okay.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile. You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty skunk. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk. You're a rotter, Mr. Grinch.
Every Who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch who lived north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season. He didn't know God loved him, that was the reason. He thought that Christians' heads weren't screwed on just right. He thought they were crazy and looked for a fight.
God doesn't love me and God doesn't care. Hypocritical Christians, they just keep waving their hands in the air. Worshiping Jesus who doesn't exist is just an excuse to buy shiny new gifts.
I think the real reason, the one most of all, was that the Grinch's heart was two sizes too small. Broken and battered as the years gone by, with him thinking that Jesus was all just a lie. But whatever the reason, the presents or ruse, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Who's. Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm, lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now hanging a mistletoe wreath.
And they're setting out presents.
He snared with a sneer.
Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here.
Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming.
I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming.
For tomorrow, he knew, all the Who girls and boys would wake bright and early. They'd rush for their toys. And then, all the noise, the noise, 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 noise. And that one thing he hated was the noise, noise, noise. Then the Who's, young and old, would sit down to a feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, feast, feast. They would feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast, which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And then they'd do something he liked least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with church bells ringing. They stand hand in hand, and the Who's would start singing. They sing, and they sing, and they sing, sing, sing. And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought.
I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming. But how?
Then he got an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
Come on, Max. Can't stand Who's. Look over here. Some other Grinches. Why is your hair not green? Thank you. How are you doing, Max? Yeah? Well, I don't know what that means. Come here, buddy. You want a tummy rub? Yeah.
Hey, it's a good boy. Yeah. It's a good boy. It's too far.
Stop it. Everybody's going to laugh at us. I'm a grown Grinch. I know just what I'll do.
The Grinch laughed in his throat and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and coat. And he chuckled and clucked.
What a Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I'll look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer.
The Grinch looked around, but since reindeer were scared, there were none to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch? No. The Grinch simply said,
"If I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead."
So he called his dog Max, and then he took some red thread and he tied a big horn on the top of his head.
That's good. Yeah, that's real nice. Yeah.
Well.
Quiet, Max. You know, like a bow, like a reindeer. Which reindeer are you? Dopey? Grumpy.
Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sled, and he hitched up old Max.
Hitch you up here, old Max. Come here. Sled. Knock it off, Max. Max. There you go. We gotta get this thing tight here. See? Too tight. How's that feel, Max? Good. I got a little knot. Always got a knot. There we go, Max. All right. Get my Santa bag. Giddy up, Max. Pull the sleigh on down. Towards the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. Whoa. Here. I need a little Who. Is there any little Who volunteers that would like to come forward? Any? How about that one right there? It's the only non-Olympian Who. Come up here, boy. Stand right here. What's your name?
Hatcher.
What?
Hatcher.
What?
Hatcher.
Oh, Hatcher. Hatcher, do you want to hear a joke?
Yes.
Do you want to be part of the joke?
Max, get out of here.
All right. What I need you to do, do you see this? Do you see this? All right. What I need you to do is open the lid. All right. Look in there. Look in. You see anything?
No.
Okay. Put your finger in there. Swirl it around. Give it a good twirl. There you can keep going. All right. Take your finger out. Smell it. Your finger. Close the lid. Thank you for cleaning my toilet.
Filled the air. All the Whos were dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first house on the square.
This is house number one.
The old Grinchy Claus hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue where the little Who stockings all hung in a row.
These stockings, I say, are the first thing to go. These people say they're Christian. They say they try. Then why do they argue, steal, blaspheme, and lie? They do what they want every Saturday night, then wake up on Sunday and think they're all right. This season right here is a perfect example of how greedy they are. Just look at this sample.
Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant. Around the whole room, and he took every present. Pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards and tricycles, popcorn and plums. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed the bags one by one up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who's pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why, he even took their last can of Who hash.
I've stuffed all the food up the chimney. Yippee! And now it's time to stuff up the tree.
And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast and noticed somewhere little Who girls who should not have been there.
What's going on here? They should be snoozing. It's Christmas Eve, and this is so confusing. I'll creep a bit closer and see what they're doing.
But the Grinch couldn't believe the sight he was viewing. The Little Who girls were kneeling by their beds, but the visions of sugar plums weren't in their heads. Instead, they were praying.
Praying? Oh dear. I'll just blink my eyes. Wah, 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 wah. And it'll all disappear. Little kids are not thankful. They're full of disgrace. Oh well, while I'm here, I'll just grab this vase.
But he paused as he heard one little girl squeak. And he listened for the voice, quiet and weak.
One more thing, Dita. Are you fake?
Thanks for the all the greater things you have made.
And we thank you, dear, for dying and being our savior.
And ask that you forgive all of the misbehavior.
If we may, we have one last request. It's the Grinch, dear Lord, I'm sure you have guessed.
Some people say he's no good. And I can't see. That he's a mean, mischief maker, a villain, a scoundrel, a deadbeat, a taker. And others, they say that he does not know you, but some say he used to leave, but then grew bored.
Or maybe he doesn't understand your grace, your compassion, your mercy so grand.
Help his eyes to be open and his spirit to grow so that we may have the same love we already know.
The Grinch paused for a moment. He coughed a deep voice.
So this Grinch has a choice?
The girls looked around, but they didn't see anyone. So the mean Grinchy Claus decided to have some fun.
Don't look around. I'm up here. It's me, God. I've been listening to you talk as you pull and you prod. This Grinch's business is his own, as is yours, can't you see? And if you're praying for more presents, then you're barking up the wrong tree.
The Tiny Who daughters were unsure of what should have been said. So they quickly said,
Amen!
And they jumped into bed. The Grinch looked around with a smirk on his face, and he started to make his way out of that place. The last thing he took was a log for the fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar.
Max!
On their walls, he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb, even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's houses, or mouses.
Max, you!
Why, yada. Max, where are you, boy?
Max. 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 Where are you, boy? Max. Max. I can't. Max, we're getting ready to go into town. Max, we're going to go out. Boy. Make sure you go to the bathroom, Max. I wish you a Grinchy Christmas. I wish you a Grinchy Christmas. Max! Max! What are you doing? Are you hiding from me? Max! Come here! Maximus! Max! Max, where have you been? Did you go to the bathroom? Max, you know when we're going out, you need to go to the restroom before we go. Max, stop playing around. I'm serious. You need to go to the bathroom. We're going to be out. Max, look. It's a long ride, and we're not going to stop. Do you understand? We're not stopping, not one time. Do you understand? What do you... Go to the bathroom, Max. Go to the bathroom. I'm serious. Max. 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 Why didn't you tell me that was back there? Max, now I need you to go to the bathroom before we leave. Now go. That's a good boy, Max. That's a good boy. Roll over, get your tummy. That's a good boy, Max. That's a good boy. Yeah, that's a good boy, Max. That's enough. Get up. Ruff is right, Max. This is rough.
The Grinch strolled past the front lawn of the church. Looking for goodies, he began to search. Looking for goodies, he began to search.
There's nothing good out here outside this old construction.
He scanned the front porch and began his abduction.
For the flowers and rugs, I will make space. But this nativity scene up here, what a waste.
It was quarter past dawn, all the hoos still abed. All the hoos still snooze when he packed up his sled. Packed it up tight with their presents, the wrappings, the ribbons, the tags, and the tinsel, the trappings. 3,000 feet up. Up the side of Mount Crumpet,
up,
he
Max.
Rode with his load to the tip top to dump it.
Thank you. poo-poo to the who's.
He was Grinchishly humming.
They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up, and I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open. For a minute or two. Then the who's down in Whoville will cry, boo hoo hoo hoo. What are you doing, Max? Keep your... They're going to know you're a dog if you keep taking these off. Keep them on there. Supposed to put the presents away. Got these things sitting out here. Max? Are you sniffing? Or sneezing? Sniff twice if you're sniffing. Sneeze twice if you're sneezing. Which one was that? A sniffer? Max? Max! Max! Alright, it's time to be serious, Max. You understand? Alright. That's a noise, I must say, that I simply must hear.
So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started out low, then it started to grow. Why, the sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry. Very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. Then he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same.
Thank you, dear God, for your gifts from above. You sent down your Son full of goodness and love. And through him you've shown us a better way of living so that one day we'll eventually join you in heaven.
And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling.
How could it be so? It came without ribbons and it came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, and bags.
And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe, just maybe, this season doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
Thank you. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. He bowed his head and he offered a prayer. The Grinch found salvation right then and right there. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he flew with his load through the bright morning light. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
This Grinch stands up in front of the whole world to say, to proclaim Jesus Christ as my Savior today. It was lying, stealing, and grumbling that I could not beat. The hatred in my heart led me to defeat. The issue in the world and in me was sin. But Jesus stands and knocks. If we would only let him in. Jesus is perfect. He never sins, you see. He is God, not like you, not like the Who's, not like me. It may be gluttony, gossip, or addiction that you face, but Jesus paid it all, and he died in your place. Simply admit to yourself and to God that you're a sinner. Jesus will forgive. Into your heart, he will enter. So believe in that heart that Jesus Christ was crucified. For you, for me, for all, he died. But death did not defeat him as he rose from the grave. And every single person, even the Who's that believe and confess, he will save. Some hate him, some ignore him, some use him, and some delay. Jesus Christ is the one, the true, the only way. So please rise, please stand, please go next door for Grinch Punch. Meet, mingle, eat, hang out. You all, the whole bunch. You have one assignment, one task, one thing to do. Tell everyone in that room who Jesus is to you. Come on, Max. Give me it!